no matter how remote or how removed you think you are from the IP process, stop and think about it. It's likely to be a very key part of talking about your technology, your invention to other people. Where I grew up is a very beautiful part of the world. It's a very untouched landscape. And as I grew up, I started to see a different side of that, which was development and growth and an impact on the environment that I loved. And so XFrame is trying to do something about that. My name is Ged Finch, or Ged. I'm the director and founder of a company called XFrame. XFrame at its core creates a modular frame that is designed to go into buildings and then be recovered at the end of its life. I've been interested in construction and prefabrication and new technologies right since I left high school, and I've been very lucky to continue that right through my education and then spin a company out. Halfway through my research process, there was a series of models, small little laser cut models, and a pattern jumped out that made sense structurally, made sense architecturally, and here it is 5 years later in buildings in Australia, New Zealand and the US. XFrame, the name, sort of just happened as it does. Our framing is X-shape. I was standing manufacturing the first prototype with a partner, and the guy asked me, oh, what do I call this file? And so lo and behold, XFrame popped out, and here we are. XFrame offers the ability to easily change the walls or the structure. We're very confident that there's no other product like it in the market. It's easily recycled, updated, reconfigured, moved, unsold. All of the things that you need to make a circular economy happen. XFrame operates within the construction market. Architects and designers love it because they see it as a new way of interacting with the building. Younger builders love it because they can see the technology in it, the innovation, the willingness to try something new. In the customer end, we're also seeing a great response from those who see value in something that they can then reuse. The XFrame technology was publicly disclosed, and that meant we had to find elements of the system that weren't disclosed or had then since evolved after that initial disclosure. So we've used a design registration as a way to protect the physical shape and look of the XFrame system, specifically in this instance a clip that holds some of the frame elements together, and then we've related that to the trademark of the XFrame brand so that we've created a comprehensive protection of the XFrame brand and system. Through the Victoria University of Wellington Technology Transfer Office, Stephanie Grant, who's the intellectual property manager, connected me with AJ Park and other intellectual property firms and then helped educate me around the process and the steps required. We've registered provisional patents in Australia, as well as registered with the Intellectual Property Office of New Zealand. Because of the way we manufacture and the way we distribute that manufacturing, we need really clear, defensible solutions for the XFrame IP. Plan for that, and speaking to people that know about what IP can be as soon as possible is really important. So although you might dismiss a patent initially, there might be other opportunities that can be extremely valuable. The XFrame IP will continue to evolve, and we're obviously constantly coming up with new ideas. And as part of that, we will always look to defend those new ideas to create a wider story and more impact.